Annissa Coy here with Firehouse Education and this week's Ask Annissa video column. This week, our question comes in from Tim. And Tim sent me an email and it was kind of lengthy, so I will kind of summarize it. What he wanted to know about was cleaning a grandfather clock. And he also wanted to know about moving a grandfather clock and said that he had seen some of my videos in the past where I had mentioned this, but I hadn't gotten into any real detail about it. So I'm going to get into some detail about a grandfather clock. Now, that is definitely a specialty piece for y'all to handle. And there are some very important things for you to know. Number one, a grandfather clock can be valued anywhere from $500 to $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 and more. It is crazy how quickly one can go from being a very inexpensive piece of furniture to extremely expensive. So I would very much recommend that you go Google and look up information on grandfather clocks and who makes them. Thomas Miller is a very expensive grandfather clock, for instance. You need to understand what the different brands are out there and how you can determine its value and then be able to go look it up. So as I've said on other videos, and I will say this again, if you have an item that is a high ticket item, you know, generally it's items worth $5,000 or more, one individual piece, oftentimes people will have what's called a rider on that item, which is like its own little mini insurance policy that is not subject to the rest of their contents insurance policy. Now, if you're in a very, very high-end home and there are lots of pieces worth $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 a piece, then you're going to often see these people insured with like Chubbs or Lloyd's of London, because those companies specialize in those kind of higher end homes and items. And then there's not going to be all these individual riders. Okay. But you will often see riders with your average home. However, whether there's a rider or not, there are some things you need to know about this grandfather clock, because if it's in someone's home, it's probably important to them, right? And whether it's worth $500 or $50,000, there are ways you need to handle it. All right. One is, never ever move a grandfather clock with the mechanisms still attached. You will ruin it. Okay. So the mechanisms actually need to be removed very carefully and removed in a certain manner so that you don't damage the clock. Once they're removed, then you pack them separately. Then you can move the clock. Then you can clean the mechanism separately from the clock, clean the clock. Then when the grandfather clock gets moved back into wherever it's going to sit and be done, right, the structure of the home, then the mechanisms can be rehung, all right? And they have to be rehung in a certain order as well so that you don't damage the clock. Now, that being said, there's also going to be some timing that needs to be done, kind of like a piano has to be retuned every time that it's moved, right? So the clock actually has some timing that needs to be done. And that always needs to be hired out by someone who is obviously trained to do it, unless you happen to know how to do that. So here's what I do when I'm handling a grandfather clock. I hire a company that comes in. They remove the mechanisms for me. I then move the clock out. I clean the clock, store the clock. Then when the clock is moved back into the home by my crew, we move it back into the home. Everything's ready to go. I have the same person that removed my timing mechanisms, the weights and such, the chains, come back, and then they reset them and retime the clock for me. Now, all of this is covered under the insurance policy as a general rule. I've not ever come across a situation where it wasn't covered. It's not horribly expensive. Again, it depends on your clock, but it can range into, you know, a few hundred dollars to maybe a few thousand dollars, but it kind of goes in line with the value of the clock. So generally that's not going to be an issue. And again, just like a piano, it has to be retuned when it's moved. These have to be retimed when they're moved, the grandfather clocks. Okay. So generally that's not going to be an issue with your adjuster, but obviously it needs to be done. So have that conversation with your homeowner and make sure that everybody's on board, as well as your adjuster. Okay. As far as cleaning the clock, I do it just like I would my general items. Oftentimes woodcraft, you know, you may HEPA vacuum. Well, obviously you're going to HEPA vacuum definitely parts of the clock. You may do dry cleaning with a chem sponge. You may do some air compression. Woodcraft is often what we use because generally these are wooden cases that are on the grandfather clocks and so on. And then obviously Windex on the glass, but they're really not that difficult to clean. The whole thing about grandfather clocks that makes them so unique and kind of a little tricky to handle is that whole moving part and the mechanisms and knowing how to remove them, knowing how to reinstall them and when, and then of course having them timed. Okay. All right. Well, I hope that answered your question. If anyone has any stories about handling a grandfather clock, be it good or bad, please send them in to me. I'd love to hear them. Annissa@firehouseeducation.com. Or you can even comment below the video here and tell us your story. All right. Well, hey guys, thanks so much for spending time with me. Don't forget to email me questions, Annissa@firehouseeducation.com. And maybe, just maybe, I will feature you on next week's Ask Annissa video column.